The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Almighty God, unto whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Hear what our Lord Jesus Christ saith. Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart and with all thy soul and with all thy mind. This is the first and great commandment. And the second is like unto it, thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. O Lord, we beseech thee mercifully to hear us, and grant that we, to whom thou hast given an hearty desire to pray, may by thy mighty aid be defended and comforted in all dangers and adversities. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who with thee in the unity of the Holy Ghost art one God, world without end.
Amen.
The epistle is written in the fifth chapter of the first epistle of St. Peter, beginning at the fifth verse. All of you be subject one to another, and be clothed with humility, for God resisteth the proud, and giveth grace to the humble. Humble yourselves, therefore, under the mighty hand of God, that he may exalt you in due time, casting all your care upon him, for he careth for you. Be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about, seeking whom he may devour, whom resist steadfast in the faith, knowing that the same afflictions are accomplished in your brethren that are in the world. But the God of all grace, who hath called us unto his eternal glory by Christ Jesus, after that ye have suffered a while, make you perfect, establish, strengthen, settle you. To him be glory and dominion forever and ever. Amen. Here endeth the epistle.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
The Holy Gospel is written in the 15th chapter of the Gospel according to St. Luke, beginning at the first verse.
Glory be to thee, O Lord.
At that time, then drew near unto Jesus all the publicans and sinners for to hear him. And the Pharisees and scribes murmured, saying, This man receiveth sinners and eateth with them. And he spake this parable unto them. What man of you, having 100 sheep, if he lose one of them, doth not leave the 99 in the wilderness, and go after that which is lost, until he find it? And when he hath found it, he layeth it on his shoulders, rejoicing. And when he cometh home, he calleth together his friends and neighbors, saying unto them, Rejoice with me, for I have found my sheep which was lost. I say unto you, that likewise joy shall be in heaven over one sinner that repenteth, more than over 99 just persons which need no repentance. Either, what woman having 10 pieces of silver, if she lose one piece, doth not light a candle and sweep the house and seek diligently till she find it? And when she hath found it, she calleth her friends and her neighbors together, saying, Rejoice with me, for I have found the piece which I had lost. Likewise, I say unto you, there is joy in the presence of the angels of God over one sinner that repenteth. Praise be to thee, O Christ.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible. And in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of his Father before all worlds, God of God, light of light, very God of very God, begotten, not made, being of one substance with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven and was incarnate by the Holy Ghost of the Virgin Mary, and was made man, and was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate. He suffered and was buried. And the third day he rose again according to the Scriptures, and ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of the Father. And he shall come again with glory to judge both the quick and the dead, whose kingdom shall have no end. And I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Lord and giver of life, who proceedeth from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spake by the prophets. And I believe one Catholic and Apostolic Church. I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins, and I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Today we're going to concentrate, I think, on two things, humility on the one hand and pride on the other. We hear the words this day from the epistle, humble yourself under the mighty hand of God, that he may exalt you in due time, and he will. That's an editorial proclamation at the end of the portion of Scripture. Humility. Thomas Aquinas wrestled with that for a period of time, and he called it a moral virtue consisting in, and this is good, keeping oneself within one's own bounds, not reaching out to things above one. Boy, if we did that, we'd be sailing through life, wouldn't we? Now, traditional theology ties humility directly to the cardinal virtue of temperance, because it inhibits our excessive ambitions while not allowing one to grovel in some self-imposed and excessive wretchedness and helplessness. And sometimes we just feel like we ought to do that, but we ought not to do it. In other words, humility cleans our heart, mind, soul, and life for the presence in the coming of Jesus. What's the opposite of humility? It's pride. Boy, don't we see that oftentimes. Pride, the father of all sin, is more easily sold to mankind, most assuredly, than humility is. Society, and we're in the midst of that peculiar society right now, society says we need to be prideful to make it in life. Toot your own horn, you know? Puff up yourself with pride. And then you can walk proudly, so we think. But animals are really our example. Dogs and cats and the like. When animals are in danger, they puff up. They get bigger than they really are, to look bigger. And how's that related? Why do they do that? Well, I'll tell you what, they want to get that person or that other animal so scared that they'll turn around and run away. But how's that related to the human condition then? Dogs and cats and animals? Well, it's akin, somewhat anyway, to what is called the Napoleonic complex, otherwise known as the little man syndrome, which describes folk who are driven by a perceived handicap, in this case being short, to the point that they overcompensate in other aspects of their life. And then so they, in essence, they fall down. When that's true, whether that's true or not, the Napoleonic problem, I'll leave that to you to determine. But I'll tell you what the spiritual equivalent of all that is. Dealing with our inadequacies in a negative way, we puff ourselves up to look bigger than even we know we are. In short, we believe our own bluster. That's called pride. And when pride is present, Christ cannot be within. Now, what did Jesus tell us about humility? Well, from my perspective, one of the best known of his teachings on this in this regard is in Matthew, where a child was in his presence, okay? And he looked at that child, and then he turned to the people that were with him, and he said, "Whosoever shall humble himself as this little child, the same is greatest in the kingdom of heaven." You see, children are gifted in that respect. Kids, babies, start out knowing that they need their parents in order to make it in life. They know they are not self-sufficient. Now you see how happy they can be. Yeah, they giggle and scream and just run around and have a fabulous time. However, the human condition comes in. However, kids have a tendency to grow up. And in the process, they may choose or adopt wrong role models in their life. And they lose their childlike humility and instead cultivate self-exaltation, pride. The way of the world is pride, not humility and love of God and one's neighbor. That's not what's touted in our society. And yet Jesus taught and also lived humility. We hear in Scripture, he humbled himself and became obedient unto death, even the death of the cross. Wherefore God also hath highly exalted him and given him a name which is above every name, Christ. Christian humility means allowing our will and life to be totally subject to God. Christ humbled himself, and what happened then? He is now exalted. Now that's our prayer this day, humility. That's our prayer this day for Joseph Julian Romano. He is a humble child, and we pray that he will continue God's faithful child until the day he dies. Humility is a call to be Christ-like, unflinchingly, and always. Humility doesn't make anyone a wimp. Some would say it does. It doesn't make anyone a wimp. It makes you strong. And it makes you Christ's. Let's stand and sing the baptismal hymn.
The order for the ministration of holy baptism begins at page 273 of the prayer book. Hath this child been already baptized or no?
No.
Dearly beloved, forasmuch as our Savior Christ saith, none can enter into the kingdom of God except he be regenerate and born anew of water and of the Holy Ghost, I beseech you to call upon God the Father through our Lord Jesus Christ, that of his bounteous mercy he will grant to this child that which by nature he cannot have, that he may be baptized with water and the Holy Ghost and received into Christ's holy church and be made a living member of the same. Let us pray. Almighty and immortal God, the aid of all who need, the helper of all who flee to thee for succor, the life of those who believe, and the resurrection of the dead, we call upon thee for this child, that he, coming to thy holy baptism, may receive remission of sin by spiritual regeneration. Receive him, O Lord, as thou hast promised by thy well-beloved Son, saying, ask, and ye shall have, seek, and ye shall find, knock, and it shall be opened unto you. So give now unto us who ask, let us who seek find, open the gate unto us who knock, that this child may enjoy the everlasting benediction of thy heavenly washing and may come to the eternal kingdom which thou hast promised by Christ our Lord. Amen. Hear the words of the gospel written by St. Mark in the 10th chapter at the 13th verse. They brought young children to Christ that he should touch them, and his disciples rebuked those that brought them. But when Jesus saw it, he was much displeased and said unto them, "Suffer the little children to come unto me, and forbid them not, for of such is the kingdom of God. Verily I say unto you, whosoever shall not receive the kingdom of God as a little child, he shall not enter therein." And he took them up in his arms and put his hands upon them and blessed them. And now, being persuaded of the goodwill of our Heavenly Father toward this child, declared by his Son Jesus Christ, let us faithfully and devoutly give thanks unto him and join in the prayer at page 276. Almighty and everlasting God, Heavenly Father, we give thee humble thanks that thou hast vouchsafed to call us to the knowledge of thy grace and faith in thee. Increase this knowledge and confirm this faith in us forevermore. Give thy Holy Spirit to this child, that he may be born again and be made an heir of everlasting salvation through our Lord Jesus Christ, who liveth and reigneth with thee and the same Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. Dearly beloved, ye have brought this child here to be baptized. Ye have prayed that our Lord Jesus Christ would vouchsafe to receive him, to release him from sin, to sanctify him with the Holy Ghost, to give him the kingdom of heaven and everlasting life. Dost thou therefore, in the name of this child, renounce the devil and all his works, the vain pomp and glory of the world, with all the covetous desires of the same and the sinful desires of the flesh, so that thou wilt not follow nor be led by them?
I renounce them all, and by thy God's help will endeavor not to follow nor be led by them.
Dost thou believe all the articles of the Christian faith as contained in the Apostles' Creed?
I do.
Wilt thou be baptized in this faith?
That is my desire.
Wilt thou then obediently keep God's holy will and commandments, and walk in the same all the days of thy life?
I will, by God's help.
Having now, in the name of this child, made these promises, wilt thou also on thy part take heed that this child learn the Creed, the Lord's Prayer, and the Ten Commandments, and all other things which a Christian ought to know and believe to his soul's health?
I will, by God's help.
Wilt thou take heed that this child, so soon as sufficiently instructed, be brought to the bishop to be confirmed by him?
I will, God being my helper.
O merciful God, grant that like as Christ died and rose again, so this child may die to sin and rise to newness of life.
Amen.
Amen. Grant that all sinful affections may die in him, and that all things belonging to the Spirit may live and grow in him.
Amen.
Grant that he may have power and strength to have victory and to triumph against the devil, the world, and the flesh.
Amen.
Grant that whosoever is here dedicated to thee by our office and ministry may also be endued with heavenly virtues and everlastingly rewarded through thy mercy, O blessed Lord God, who dost live and govern all things, world without end.
Amen.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up unto the Lord.
Let us give thanks unto our Lord God.
It is meet and right to do so.
It is very meet, right, and our bounden duty that we should give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, everlasting God, for that thy dearly beloved Son, Jesus Christ, for the forgiveness of our sins, did shed out of his most precious side both water and blood, and gave commandment to his disciples that they should go teach all nations and baptize them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. Regard, we beseech thee, the supplications of thy congregation. Sanctify this water to the mystical washing away of sin, and grant that this child, now to be baptized therein, may receive the fullness of thy grace and ever remain in the number of thy faithful children through the same Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with thee and the unity of the Holy Spirit be all honor and glory, now and evermore.
Amen.
Amen. Name this child.
Joseph Julian Romano.
If you hold him over the phone, please. Joseph Julian Romano, I baptize thee in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. We receive this child into the congregation of Christ's flock, and do sign him with the sign of the cross, in token that hereafter he shall not be ashamed to confess the faith of Christ crucified and manfully to fight under his banner against sin, the world, and the devil, and to continue Christ's faithful soldier and servant unto his life's end. Amen.
Amen. Joseph, I want to take you and have everybody look at you because it's so beautiful and handsome. There you go.
He's going to be a preacher.
Seeing now, dearly beloved brethren, that this child is regenerate and grafted into the body of Christ's church, let us give thanks unto Almighty God for these benefits and with one accord make our prayers unto him that this child may lead the rest of his life according to this beginning. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. We yield thee hearty thanks, most merciful Father, that it hath pleased thee to regenerate this child with thy Holy Spirit, to receive him for thine own child, and to incorporate him into thy holy church. And humbly we beseech thee to grant that he, being dead unto sin, may live unto righteousness, and being buried with Christ in his death, may also be partaker of his resurrection, so that finally, with the residue of thy holy church, he may be an inheritor of thine everlasting kingdom, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, of whom the whole family in heaven and earth is named, grant you to be strengthened with might by his Spirit in the inner man, that Christ, dwelling in your hearts by faith, ye may be filled with all the fullness of God. Amen. If you'd like to go ahead and take your seats.
Amen. Let us pray for the whole state of Christ's church. Almighty and ever-living God, who by thy holy apostle has taught us to make prayers and supplications and to give thanks for all men, we humbly beseech thee most mercifully to accept our alms and oblations and to receive these our prayers, which we offer unto thy divine majesty, beseeching thee to inspire continually the universal church with a spirit of truth, unity, and concord. And grant that all those who to confess thy holy name may agree in the truth of thy holy word and live in unity and godly love. We beseech thee also so to direct and dispose the hearts of all Christian rulers, that they may truly and impartially administer justice to the punishment of wickedness and vice, and to the maintenance of thy true religion and virtue. Give grace, O Heavenly Father, to all bishops and other ministers, that they may, both by their life and doctrine, set forth thy true and lively word, and rightly and duly administer thy holy sacraments. And to all thy people give thy heavenly grace, and especially to this congregation here present, that with meek heart and due reverence they may hear and receive thy holy word, truly serving thee in holiness and righteousness all the days of their life. And we most humbly beseech thee of thy goodness, O Lord, to comfort and succor all those who in this transitory life are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity. And we also bless thy holy name for all thy servants departed this life in thy faith and fear, beseeching thee to grant them continual growth in thy love and service, and to give us grace so to follow their good examples, that with them we may be partakers of thy heavenly kingdom. Grant this, O Father, for Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and advocate. He who do truly and earnestly repent you of your sins and are in love and charity with your neighbors and intend to lead a new life, following the commandments of God and walking from henceforth in his holy ways, draw near with faith and take this holy sacrament to your comfort and make your humble confession unto Almighty God, devoutly kneeling. Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, maker of all things, judge of all men, we acknowledge and bewail our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time most grievously have committed by thought, word, and deed against thy divine majesty, provoking most justly thy wrath and indignation against us. We do earnestly repent and are heartily sorry for these our misdoings. The remembrance of them is grievous unto us. The burden of them is intolerable. Have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father, for thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake. Forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may ever hereafter serve and please thee in newness of life, to the honor and the glory of thy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, our heavenly Father, who of his great mercy hath promised forgiveness of sins to all those who with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto him, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Hear what comfortable words our Savior Christ hath to all who truly turn to him. Come unto me, all ye that travail and are heavy laden, and I will refresh you. So God loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, to the end that all that believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Hear also what St. Paul said. This is a true saying, and worthy of all men to be received, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. Hear also what St. John saith, if any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he is the propitiation for our sins. The Lord be with you.
And with our spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up unto the Lord.
Let us give thanks unto our Lord God.
It is very
meet, right, and our bounden duty that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, almighty everlasting God. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying, pray. All glory be to the Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, With the thou of thy tender mercy didst give thine only Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, who made there, by his one oblation of himself once offered, a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation, and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world, and did institute and in his holy gospel command us to continue a perpetual memory of that, his precious death and sacrifice, until his coming again. For in the night in which he was betrayed, he took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Likewise, after supper, he took the cup. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink ye all of this. For this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as ye shall drink it in remembrance of me." Wherefore, O Lord and Heavenly Father, according to the institution of thy dearly beloved Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, we, thy humble servants, do celebrate and make here before thy divine majesty, with these thy holy gifts, which we now offer unto thee, the memorial thy Son hath commanded us to make, having in remembrance his blessed passion and precious death, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, rendering unto thee most hearty thanks for the innumerable benefits procured unto us by the same. And we most humbly beseech thee, O merciful Father, to hear us, and of thy almighty goodness vouchsafe to bless and sanctify with thy word and Holy Spirit these thy gifts and creatures of bread and wine, that we, receiving them according to thy Son, our Savior Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. And we earnestly desire thy fatherly goodness mercifully to accept this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, most humbly beseeching thee to grant that by the merits and death of thy Son, Jesus Christ, and through faith in his blood, we and all thy whole church may obtain remission of our sins and all other benefits of his passion. And here we offer and present unto thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls and bodies, to be a reasonable, holy, and living sacrifice unto thee, humbly beseeching thee that we and all others who shall be partakers of this holy communion may worthily receive the most precious body and blood of thy Son, Jesus Christ, be filled with thy grace and heavenly benediction, and made one body with him, that he may dwell in us and we in him. And although we are unworthy, through our manifold sins, to offer unto thee any sacrifice, yet we beseech thee to accept this, our bounden duty and service, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offenses through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, all honor and glory be unto thee, O Father Almighty, world without end. Amen. Let us pray now as our Savior Christ hath taught us. We are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Deliver us, we beseech thee, O Lord, from all evils, past, present, and to come. And in the intercession of all thy saints, grant peace favorably in our day, that we, being hopened by the succor of thy mercy, may be both free from sin and safe from all disquietude. To the same and to our world without end.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you. O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world, grant us thy peace. O Lord Jesus Christ, who sent of thine apostles, peace I leave with you, my peace I give unto you. Regard not my sins, but the faith of thy church, and grant to it that peace and unity which is according to thy will, who livest and reignest, God, world without end. Amen. We do not presume to come to this thy table, O merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in thy manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under thy table, but thou art the same Lord, whose property is always to have mercy. Grant us, therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of thy dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that our sinful bodies may be made clean by his body, and our souls washed through his most precious blood, and that we may evermore dwell in him, and he in us.
Amen.
I receive the bread of heaven, and call upon the name of the Lord, and with my strength and my salvation. Lord, I'm not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof, but speak the word only, my soul shall be healed. Lord, I'm not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof, but speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed. Lord, I'm not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof, but speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him that taketh away the sins of the world. The body of our Lord and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for thee, preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life. Take and eat this in the remembrance that Christ died for thee, and feed on him in thy heart by faith with thanksgiving. The body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for thee, preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life. Take and eat this in the remembrance that Christ died for thee, and feed on him in thy heart by faith with thanksgiving. The body of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost be upon you this day and always. Amen. The body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for thee, preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life. Take and eat this in the remembrance that Christ died for thee, and feed on him in thy heart by faith with thanksgiving. Amen. The Lord be with you.
With thy spirit.
Let us pray. Almighty and ever living God, We most heartily thank thee for that thou dost vouchsafe to feed us who have duly received these holy mysteries with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of thy Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, and dost assure us thereby of thy favor and goodness towards us, and that we are very members incorporated in the mystical body of thy Son, which is the blessed company of all faithful people, and are also heirs through hope of thy everlasting kingdom by the merits of his most precious death and passion. And we humbly beseech thee, O Heavenly Father, so to assist us with thy grace, that we may continue in that holy fellowship and do all such good works as thou hast prepared for us to walk in. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honor and glory, world without end.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Depart in peace.
Thanks be to God. The peace of God, which passeth all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost be amongst you and remain with you always.
Amen.
Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle, be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray, and do thou, O Prince of the heavenly hosts, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl through the world. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Praise, blessed, and adored be our Lord Jesus Christ, on his most glorious throne in heaven, in the most holy sacrament of the altar, and in the hearts of his faith-filled people. May the souls of the faithful departed, through the mercies of God, rest in peace. You're going to be a preacher. You can sing loud. You're a good boy. Yes, you are. I love you. Yeah. Good. Whole cadre of people here today.
Yes.
Are you? That's good. That's good. The Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
May the souls of the faithful departed through the mercies of God rest in peace.
And the light perpetual shine upon them. Amen.
Lord, deliver these United States.